What's going on, dreamers, and welcome back to SpongeBob the movie game. Now, we've completed the first chapter, which was pretty somewhat easy, and I probably should have played a little bit of the second chapter, but I didn't realize I only did like two takes, which I probably could have done. Like I said, I could have done a little more here for the third take and didn't realize that, but it is what it is. So don't forget to hit that like button, also subscribe so we can reach 40 subscribers. Let's go. All right, let's go. Chapter 2. There we go. You have no customers, so what's the point of doing this?
I never have any customers, but don't cry for me. I use the rejection constructively to feed the evil.
He says the same thing with this. It's weird. Kitchen. Exit the chum bucket. Why would I ever do that? Anything else I can look at? Anyways. Be too. Detailed with this, Jesus Christ. All right. Boop. Karen.
Down here.
What do you want?
I need to find a way to steal.
I need to find a way to steal Mr. Krabs' secret Krabby Patty recipe. I've tried everything I can think of.
In other words, not much.
You are helping.
Have you checked all the evil plans in your filing cabinet?
Yes, every last one, from A to Y. There is nothing left.
What about C?
C?
C? The letter after Y?
Girls?
Oh, boy. Attempt to take over the world.
I have one word for you, magnet.
You couldn't lift it.
Storage area. Oh.
I can't get to it. That plastic SpongeBob robot might squash me. I'll need to get him to move first.
Ooh, I could take this mop. He doesn't have the brain.
A wrench can be quite a precision tool, as long as you know exactly where to throw it.
lights are out. Okay.
I can't do that. I can't get to it. That bastard SpongeBob robot might squash me. I'll need to get him to move first.
Right, okay. Let's go to the files. I go into the door. I go exiting the kitchen.
Not even close. I have a college diploma for Neptune's sake.
Oh. Okay, sorry about that.
Jeez, what a stupid robot. Jeez, what a stupid robot.
All right, now I can go get my thing. Now I can leave this place. I can leave the chum bucket now, thank goodness. God, I hate puzzles that are really tough to figure out.
I can't possibly get to Neptune's castle without my jetpack. Think, man, think! It's my
jetpack. There we go. I see. Now this is click-based, really, so I don't really need to do too much or use the keys. And I'm sorry about that whole darkness that showed up randomly. It was very weird. Jellyfish. 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 Gotta love jellyfish. This isn't too difficult, really. Ooh, almost got me there. Ooh. There's so many jellyfish, it's so weird. There we go. Okay.
Ah, Neptune's castle. Why don't I have a castle you may very well ask? Sadly, that question lacks a satisfactory answer. Anyway, let's get down to business.
Right.
Telltale signs of civil unrest. Glorious.
Right.
I'd better not. They probably wouldn't be very friendly, and their boots look heavy.
All right, into the stables. Steven, horseshoe. Seahorses. Oh, there's the jellyfish that look freaking 2D style. I'm gonna take this.
Seahorses don't even have feet. What genius thought of these?
Something to do with the horseshoe.
I don't think so. Even trying that is ill-befitting of an evil genius such as I. You wouldn't need a battering ram to break these down. A battering worm would do just fine.
Right. Oh.
It's an image of a book. I guess that's so people who can't read have no trouble finding the library. Probably save a lot of electricity that way. I'll have to look into implementing a similar scheme at the chill planet. A penny saved is a penny added to the plankton fund for total global control.
Right.
That is quite possibly the coolest thing I've ever seen.
Right. Okay. Might as well enter the library. Into the library. This chapter is so long.
Hello, clown.
What? Who's there?
Down here.
Yikes. Sea life. Please don't bite me.
I am not a louse, and I would never bite you. I don't know where you've been.
I knew we needed to get the castle tended.
Listen, Tony, I need information.
What do you want from me?
I'm trying to get into the throne room. I have important business with King Neptune. Now, how would I do that?
You probably want to bite him.
I assure you, I do not.
The doors to the throne room are electric. There's a button on the side that slides them open. I call it the electric slide button.
I can't reach it.
Yes, you're going to have to fight someone else then.
Can you help me open the doors?
I'm not opening the doors for a louse.
For the last time, I am not a louse.
Well, I'm not opening the doors for you anyway. There's a nail sticking out of the wood next to the button, and my hat always gets caught on it. I'm not risking my 30-70 cotton blend for anybody, especially a louse.
A nail, huh?
Interesting.
You're a jester, right? Do something funny.
How about this?
Wow, limper. So, how do you like your job?
It's all right, I guess. But I don't like living in this castle. It's really gone downhill lately. I mean, look at this carpet. There's a loose thread right there. It It's embarrassing.
I've gotta go.
You can say that again.
Ooh. Oh, I wanted the book. Climb the ladder.
That demonstrates a defined lack of evil. I refuse.
Okay. Oh, it's a loose thread. Oh, that's where it is.
It might be a thread to some, but to me it is a coil of the strongest rope.
Right, strongest rope.
Aha! There. It's a stinky seahorseshoe with a thread tied to it. Genius, I tell you!
Alright, I don't think there's anything else here for me to do, so I'm just gonna go to the hall now. God, he walks forever. To the Hall of Neptune. Stairs. Downstairs. Into the throne room. Let's get this act started nicely.
You have got to be kidding.
Pedestal. Alright, let's go to the pedestal then. We're gonna go steal a crown. Chapter 3, hit the road. Don't hit that road. Squidward.
Hey there, Squidward. I just wanted to say congratulations on the promotion.
A lot of good it does me with Mr. Krabs frozen. Who's gonna sign my new and improved paychecks?
To show that I have no hard feelings, I'd be more than happy to sign your paychecks.
Yeah, no.
Really are a knucklehead McSpasmatron.
So I need to get to Shell City quickly. I'm gonna use Mr. Krabs' Patty-mobile to get there. What do you think about that?
Yeah.
Do you know where Mr. Krabs keeps the Patty-mobile?
It's in an underground cavern beneath the restaurant. You can get to it through the kitchen, but you need a pass card to use the elevator.
Barnacles, where can I get one?
Well, as manager, I was issued a pass card just today.
Woo! Can I have it?
No, you didn't.
But I need it!
I lost it, okay? I was cleaning the table, and it must have fallen out of my bucket. There were a couple of kids in here earlier, a boy and a girl. I bet one of them took it.
Barnacles.
Don't tell Mr. Krabs, if he ever gets unfrozen, that is.
Well, goodbye, Manager Squidward. I have to go save Mr. Krabs now. Shell City. I'm going to go get it and save the day.
I've heard rumors to that effect. So what are you doing standing around here talking to me? Why don't you get Krabs' Patty-mobile and get going?
I plan to. There are a few things I need to do first, though.
Well, don't take too long. I've heard he doesn't have much time.
Say, you wouldn't happen to know where the Patty-mobile is, would you?
Well, I'm no gossip, but I've heard it's parked in an underground lair right beneath this very restaurant.
Yeah, so this guy is from a different SpongeBob game, one of the CD ones. I've seen him before. I don't remember exactly what that one was called, but it was a different SpongeBob game that had, like, it was pretty decent. It was okay. I was just running around helping people, really. That's pretty much the whole game. Repairman! For him.
The good old Krusty Krab. I wish I could look at it without remembering the humiliation.
All right, turn on the loudspeaker then. Did it again. walking to the second restaurant. Okay. Perch Perkins.
Wow. You're Perch Perkins, the news reporter.
Why, yes I am. How nice for you to meet me.
That's not his voice.
Isn't the report over?
Well, yes and no. Part of being a good news reporter is being able to anticipate events. But I think Mr. Krabs getting fried will be the story of the week.
Oh, well, if that's why you're here, you can just go home. I'm gonna save him. Me and my buddy Patrick are going to go get the crown back from Shell City.
Don't be offended, but I think I'll take my chances.
Right.
If I save Mr. Krabs, will you do a hero piece on me?
Hero pieces don't skew as well as deep-fried crab pieces. But perhaps, who knows?
Yeah, me! Well, I need to get going. Saving Mr. Krabs and all that, you know?
Yes, well, good luck with that.
Right. Nope. Sorry, I just like to do stuff for no reason. I know a lot of people can relate. Why is this one say Krusty Krab, but this one has two on it? Weird. Oh, there's the kid. Little girl, give me the card.
Hello there, little girl.
Hi.
What are you doing?
I'm standing.
Wow, me too.
Yep.
Hey, have you seen a card with little holes punched in it lying around?
Oh, you mean the super powerful magic plastic thingy?
Maybe. You seen it?
Yep.
Do you have it?
Nope, Morty has it.
Oh, who's Morty?
My friend.
Do you know where he is?
He went to Goofy Cooper.
Goofy.
He said he wanted some weird ice cream.
Thanks, I'm gonna go. Have a nice day.
Bye.
Cashier. I know he's not there, he's in the other one, but still. I don't know if it'll let me go through. Oil! Sink. Oh, it's got an eye. Okay, let's get out of this kitchen. Please, get out of the kitchen.
Mr. Krabs wouldn't want me snooping around in his office when he's not here.
He's not even... He's in the other office. I mean, he's only... Okay.
Mr. Krabs sure has collected a lot of worthless junk over the years.
Yeah. That's for sure. Gooby Goobers, I guess. Yep.
Well, I guess if I'm going to find Morty, I better visit Gooby Goobers. Strictly business, though.
Right. Strictly business. What is this? Why was there like animation for that? Oh my god. All right.
That can't be good for the ocean.
Why does he even need one of those? I guess, I mean, it is technically a ship. Oh, there's the kid. Okay. Oh, it's him again.
Popcorn!
Aw. Oh. I want to talk to this guy first. Yep.
Goofy Goober is my hero.
It's okay.
Hey, what's that thing on the table?
It's my super magic fairy card of power. I found it in the Krusty Krab.
Ooh, can I have it?
No, I found it. It's mine.
I'll be your bestest Pokemon.
No. That's not even a thing.
So, fried ice cream, huh?
Yep.
Okay, I got it.
Good luck. They don't make it here.
Well, I gotta go. Important matters demand my attention.
What's at the stage? Oh, hey.
Goofy
Goober! Oh, hello there, little goob. Welcome to Goofy Goober's.
Little goob.
I bet you get people going a little goofy in here all the time.
Not really. Yesterday was a bad day, though. There was you, and then there were these two guys that work at the gas station on the county line. They were making quite a scene.
Oh, yeah? What were they doing?
Dancing on the table, singing really, really loud. One of them insisted I give him the sheet music to the Goofy Goober theme song. I mean, really? They were a bit old for that sort of thing.
Bye, Goofy Goober.
Alright. Set the stage. Pretty much. As much as I want to keep going, I'm gonna have to cut here. Alright, so that's gonna be it for this one. Don't forget to hit that like button. Like button, also subscribe, so we can reach 40 subscribers. That'd be wonderful. And we'll advance the story more later, so in another time. So I guess on that note, bye.